Hello, it's me back cooking again. Over the last few years, I've been beavering away on my PNGTuber model, improving and adding new poses as I go along. You can check out my progress in this playlist featuring all the previous videos that I've done did. I honestly wouldn't be surprised if you're getting tired of hearing me say PNGTuber so much lately.
PNGTuber.
Wait, is it PNGTuber or PNGTuber? Have I been saying it wrong all this time? One thing I didn't really go into much detail about in those previous videos was the program I'm using to perform these acts of fancy. Acts of fancy? What am I going on about? The program in question is Veadotube Mini, created by Almimi and Bella! While there are plenty of other PNGTuber programs out there, this is the one I've clung on to all this time, because it's just so simple and fun to use, especially since the 2.0 update earlier this year that added a whole bunch of new bells and whistles. Not literal bells and whistles, that'd be silly. Although... I've had quite a few of you out there on the YouTubes asking me how to use this software. While I could just yeet you all over to the help page on Veado.tube and call it a day, I feel like giving you all a wee tour of it. Right here. Right now. This is what you'll see when you first boot the software up. A blank canvas. The first thing you want to do is set up your microphone, the only piece of additional hardware you'll need. Veadotube doesn't use a webcam to track your head movements, just your voice. Once your microphone is hooked up, you can select it from the microphone settings here. Boink, there's my one. If successful, you should see your mic gauge bobbing up and down here as you talk. If you look at the green wobbly line, you'll see a little arrow. This is your microphone volume cutoff. Depending on the setup and environment, there will most likely be a wobbling lower level of background noise that is always there, even when you're completely silent. See it? You'll want the cutoff to be just above where this background noise is, which you can tinker by moving this arrow up and down, like so. That way your avatar will only flap their lips when you speak. If you click down in the left corner here on Avatar Settings, and then click Load Default Avatar, you can try out a few example avatars that old Mimi and Bella have created for inspiration. I especially love this sock puppet one. Look at him go! Look at him go! I love him. Before we can start plopping some assets of your character of choice in here, let's first talk about what you're gonna need. For any pose you create, you'll want variants like this. One stationary, one talking, one blinking, one talking and blinking. Bare minimum, you'll want at least the talking and the not talking, but the blinking will help your character look more alive, even when they're not talking. These can be static images or animated in either GIF or PNG format, preferably with transparency. Maximum resolution is 2048 by 2048, so plenty of room to work with, even if you livestream or create videos in 4K. Don't worry about having the final fully rendered assets ready before you start using this program though, as you can replace the assets at any time. So chuck your sketchy drafts in, if you like. Once you have something you want to try out synced to your voice, here's how you add them to the program. So you see this little box in the corner here that says State Number 1? Just click on that and you'll see this new menu pop up. These four icons with little faces on them are where you're going to be adding your assets for the pose. So the first icon is the closed mouth image. This is the image for when your character is completely silent. Click on that and just find the file you want. In this case, I'm going to go with this one here and plop it in. Right, there we go. There's our first asset. So the next one along is the open mouth image for when you're talking. So just repeat the process, find your asset that you want to use, and voila. If you already set your microphone up, your character will instantly and automatically sync to your voice. It's magical. The last two of these head icons are for blinking images. The first for blinking your eyes when silent, and the second for blinking while talking. But let's add those in. Once you've uploaded these, now your character will start automatically blinking. Unlike the talking, the blinking is set to a timer. To be honest, I have always kept this timing on its default settings, but if you did want your character to blink more or less often, the pencil icon down here gives you the options to change this by sliding this bar about. In this section, you can also give the state a name, so I'm going to call this one Default. If you want to replace images or remove images, just click on the image that you have in the corner and you can just remove it and replace it from here. You can also export the image that you put in here and it will save it to your computer just in case you've somehow deleted the original files but they're still within this. So the next icon we're going to be focusing on underneath the pencil is this shouty little man. This is the state effects settings, and this is where you can tinker about with how your character will hop, rotate, spin and shake about with an absurd amount of customization. First two panels are for what movement your character will make when silent or talking, and the lower two are for when the character starts talking or finishes talking. We'll first focus on the lower two panels, as they really only serve one purpose. If you want your character to do a short little hop at the start or the end of talking, click on the plus on either of these panels and click jump. Now you'll notice that when I talk, I do a little hop. Hop, hop, hoppity hop. In most cases, I like the default settings here too, but if you wanted to tweak this further, click on the jump that you added and you'll see you now have some extra tweakage here. Like you can adjust how much the character jumps, boing, boing, and you can also change the velocity, so how long or short it is. So I can go pop, 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 or I can pop a like, doing. And obviously, if you don't like any of this stuff, you can also just put it back on default. These top two panels have many, many more options to play with. Let's have a look at them. First up, we have Darken. Darken lets you dim your character without the need to manually do so in your art assets. This defaults to 50%, but you can do it from anywhere between 0% and 100%. And as with all of these effects, they can be applied to when the mouth is shut or open. So I could even put it on both. For example, let's crank that one up to 100. Silhouette, silhouette. If you want to hide an effect, click this little eye and it will just get rid of them. Or if you want to delete them completely, click the little X's. Right, let's go on to the next one. So the jump function here has a lot more options, including three defaults to try out. Bouncy, excited, and nervous. You can fully customize the amount of vertical and horizontal movement and the velocity here too. Let's crank it all the way up. Way! Way! The next one down is Random Move. This one has three defaults. Vibing, shaking, and shaking more. You can also adjust the amount of shaking and the velocity. Whoa. Now Wave Move, I find this one's really good for slower movements. The defaults here are Breathing, which goes up and down, and Circling, which rotates in a circle. The X and Y axis, time period of the movement, and even the period offset are here to muck about with. Wee, wee, oh god, wee. And finally, we have Wave Rotate, which does exactly what it says on the tin and rotates your character, rocking them back and forth. Here we've got Wobbling and Wobbling More as defaults. This one lets you adjust the angle so you get really wild and just go all the way up to 90. Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo. And you can also change how quickly it does it as well. Be warned that this could affect the cropping of your character, depending on how you've rendered them. Another thing I would recommend is to maybe make both the open and closed mouth effects roughly the same, if not exactly the same. As you'll notice, if I don't do that, it's a little bit jerky going between the closed mouth and the open mouth. But if you were to have similar settings for both, you'll notice it's nice and smooth. For many people, one pose is going to be plenty to get started on their PNGTuber adventure, but I'm going to show you what to do if you want to create additional poses. But first, let's not forget to save. This can be done in the avatar settings in the bottom left corner here under Save Avatar. Boink, saved. Oh, and if you close the program without saving, don't panic, as next time you open it, you'll be precisely where you left off. Still, don't forget to save. Because we only have one pose currently, we won't be needing this button of, well, a button just yet. So let's click on our current state in the top corner to close its menu. There you'll notice there's a little plus symbol under your current state. Clicking on this will create a copy of the previous state. As far as I know, there isn't a way to create a blank state, but no worries, as you can remove the images and movement options from the new clone state if you like. There you go, so we're going to start from scratch. From here you can upload new assets and tinker with the movement options just as you did with the previous state. Let's do that. How's it going? Oh yeah, and don't forget to name your new state so you can turn them apart. I'm going to name this one Juke. So now that we have two poses, we want to be able to switch between them without having to manually click on them like this. Boink, boink, boink. This is where that button of a button that I mentioned earlier comes in handy. And here it is. The hardest button to button. The state of shortcuts button, located at the bottom of each state's menu. Click on this and then click on assign shortcut and it will come up with waiting for input. You can assign any button from your computer's keyboard, a mouse click, or even any buttons on an X input game controller or MIDI controller. So I'm going to press a button on my MIDI controller and you'll see the command pops up for a second there. And now you'll see that the command has been added, so you know that it's done. So if I do this for both poses, like so, now we can switch between the poses with ease. Bink, bonk, bink, bonk. But what if you, for example, want your first state to be the default and want the second pose to only pop up when you hold its shortcut key? Well, if you click on the state shortcut button again, you'll now have more options. You can change or remove the shortcut key here, but most importantly, we have this activation mode toggle. On press is the default, you press it and the state changes. On release lets you hold the button and change the state when you let go of the button. But while pressed is the most handy in my opinion, as it lets you change the pose as you hold the button, then switches back to the previous pose when you let go. So I'm holding the button, letting go, holding it, letting go. Blah, 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 blah. Oh, by the way, you can also reorder these poses by literally clicking and dragging them around, like so. Boink. And that's the basics for how to set up your different poses and how to perform them, so to speak. For details on how to place your PNGTuber into OBS or Streamlabs, this will vary depending on your setup and operating system. So I would suggest checking out the Veadotube website's detailed guide, as there are many ways this can be done, such as creating a simple game or window capture, or using something like the Sprout 2 plugin to add your character to your stream layout without the UI of Veadotube displaying. Here are some other options on the left side of the screen that might prove useful to you. Going back to the microphone settings, there are some noise cancelling options you can try out here if you need them, called Celero and Oculus. Also, if you want to sync your PNGTuber's voice to something other than your microphone, this can be done too. If you have stereo mix on a Windows setup enabled, for example, you can sync any audio from your computer, even music. Fire, fire, like a soldier. Below the microphone is the display settings. From here you can mess about with the scale of your avatar. Boink. You can also adjust the position to anywhere you like. Poof. Down here now. Movement scale is a bit of a weird one, as it just makes the movement of your character more exaggerated. For example, if I crank it all the way up, boop, boop, notice my jump is a lot higher now. I'd suggest keeping this one on the default of 100% to be honest. You can also change the colour of the backgrounds to anything your heart desires. You can also set it to a transparent grid like this, or even an image. You can upload any image you want and stick it in the background, which is nice. The program settings menu has a lot of settings that you'll most likely not need to mess about with. The Spout Steam option is for the Spout 2 plugin integration in OBS. And the WebSocket server? This is what I'll turn on if I wanted to use my Stream Deck with Veadotube Mini. If I had one! Keep All States Loaded is on by default, and I would highly recommend keeping it that way, as if you were to turn it off, switching between poses becomes a lot more sluggish as it has to load in each pose on the fly, as opposed to loading them all in at once by holding them in memory. But if I turn that back on, there you go, much quicker. This can have a knockback on your RAM, but I'd say only turn this off if your computer is really struggling otherwise. You can also set the program to hide the UI when you unfocus the window, like this. Or you can turn off the UI completely until you double click on the program, which can be useful. Before I bid you adieu, I'll show you my current full setup of poses. But as you can see, I have an absurd amount of poses. This one literally just uses the default jump. The wave has a wave rotate, and as you'll notice, they both have the exact same settings, so it's consistent. This one actually has a different percentage of random movement depending on whether the mouth is shut or open. So when it's open, it shakes just a little bit more. And this one uses the wave move, so it rotates around in the circle, again using the same settings on both the open and closed mouth, so it doesn't jerk about. I even have a couple of incomplete sketch poses sitting down here, not assigned to buttons yet. Will I get around to fully rendering these one day? Perhaps.
I hope you found that little tour of Veadotube Mini to be useful for getting started on your first PNGTuber. I highly recommend checking this software out, even if you don't plan to create a PNGTuber, as syncing animation to your voice is just such a fun experience and it's so easy to just plonk stuff in and experiment. If you've created a PNGTuber and perform it with this software, please show it off in the comments. I really want to see your characters and how they animate to your voice. Until next time.
Bella!